These two energies are equal and acting in the opposite direction. These two energies are equal and this gravitational potential and they are acting in the opposite direction. Then these two equations are equal. Now half mve square is equal to minus half minus gmm by r. Now here half mve square is equal to minus into minus, that is gmm by r. Here mm gets cancelled, then ve square is equal to 2gm by r. Then ve is equal to square root of 2gm by r. This is the escape velocity of an object from the earth. Here capital M is the mass of the earth and r is the radius of the earth. Here this equation we can write as in terms of g, that is g is equal to gm by r square, that is gm is equal to g into r square. Now substituting here, ve is equal to under root g 2 into g r square by r, that is ve is equal to, we can get 2gr, under root 2gr. This is the escape velocity of an object from the earth surface. Here if we observe this equation, ve is equal to under root 2gm by r, then the escape velocity of an object does not depend on mass of the object. The escape velocity of an object does not depend on mass of an object. It depends on the mass of the earth, or it depends on mass of the planet, and also depends on radius of the planet, but it doesn't depend on the mass of an object. Here this is the escape velocity. Escape velocity means the minimum amount of velocity required for an object to escape from the earth's gravitational field is called escape velocity. Here the gravitational potential energy U is equal to minus gmm by r. Here to escape from the earth's surface, that object needs the gravitational potential energy minus gmm by r, and the minimum, and it has kinetic energy half mve square. These two equations are equating, then half mve square is equal to gmm by r. Here this minus denotes, here these two energies are equal and acting in the opposite direction. Then ve is equal to, will get under root 2gm by r, or ve is equal to, will get under root 2gr. Now orbital velocity. What is orbital velocity? And this orbital velocity is denoted with V naught. Here orbital velocity means the velocity required for an object to revolve round the planet. The velocity required for an object to revolve round the planet, that is called orbital velocity of an object. Here now I am considering capital M mass of the planet we are considering, and the radius of the planet is capital R. Now here I am considering around this planet, I am considering small m mass of an object is revolving round this planet. Now this planet is at a height h. This planet is at a height h from the above the surface of the earth. Now the total distance from this center of the earth to this object is r plus h. Now already we know this planet is this object is revolving round the earth, means here it has some velocity. That velocity is orbital velocity v naught. And here to move any object around in a circle, then the centripetal force is acting on the object towards the center. Here that centripetal force, I am writing centripetal force. That centripetal force is equal to mv naught square by r plus h. Here this is the centripetal force is acting on this object, that is mv naught square by r plus h. And between these two objects, that is between m mass of an object to capital M mass of the planet, the gravitational force is acting, and that gravitational force is F is equal to G M M by R plus H whole square. Here this is the centripetal force and this is the gravitational force, and these two are acting in the equal and in the opposite direction, then that object can revolve around the planet. Then these two equations are equating. Now mv naught square by r plus h is equal to gmm by r plus h whole square. Now this one r plus h, here r plus h cancel, then mm also cancel, then v naught square is equal to gm by r plus h, and v naught is equal to under root gm by r plus h. This is the equation for orbital velocity. Here the orbital velocity v naught is equal to under root capital gm by r plus h. Here orbital velocity means the minimum velocity required for an object to revolve around the planet, that is by centripetal force we have mv naught square by r plus h, and gravitational force F is equal to gmm by r plus h whole square. Here these two forces are equal, then only the object can revolve around the earth. Then mv naught square by r plus h is equal to gmm by r plus h whole square, then we'll get v naught is equal to under root gm by r plus h. For example, here this h is equal to 0, then we'll get v naught is equal to under root gm by capital R. Here v naught is equal to gm by capital R will get, or by this g is equal to, we can write gr square is equal to gm, we can write, then in that v naught is equal to, we can write under root gr also we can write. Here this is the orbital velocity.